Good afternoon, everyone. Today we're going to discuss about the topic that is plant breeding terms and history. So in this, I have segregated the topic according to the various parts like of the breeding section we are going to deal with. So first one is based on the flowers and the plants. So some plants we will be discussing over here. So the first term over here is the anther. Anther is the pollen bearing portion of the stamen. That is the stamen. We know that a flower has four holes from outside to inside. First one is sepal, then petal, then stamen and carpel. Okay, sepal and petal are non-reproductive organs, and stamen is the male reproductive part and carpel is the female reproductive part. Okay, so anther is the top portion of the stamen. This is something like this, and this is the stake of the anther, and this is the stake of the stamen. So this portion is the where the pollens are kept, and upon bursting of the anther, the pollens are released. The next term is the anthesis, which is the dehiscence of the anthers to release the pollen, and opening of the flower is called as anthesis. Then next term is the bolting. Bolting is the production of seed stalks in the first season in the biennial crop. Okay, in the biennial crop, normally what happens is in second season, the plant goes to flowering. If in the first season only, the plant will go for, that condition will be called as bolting. Okay, it is seen in case of your onion also, sugar beet also. Then in case of arrow, you can see that arrow is the inflorescence of the sugarcane. This is very important term, several times asked in the exams. Then boa is a toxin that is present in case of the crop that is grass pea or commonly called as lethyrus. This is a neurotoxin. If it is consumed in much higher level, it may cause severe damage, fatal to human being. Then based on the topic of mode of pollination, I have given some terms, that is sexual reproduction, asexual reproduction. So in basically reproduction is the two types, that is sexual and asexual. Sexual reproduction, where the fusion of the gamete occurs, and asexual one, there is no fusion of the gamete, and here your progeny or the offspring will be developed from the somatic cell, not the reproductive ones. Somatic cell tissue or organs, here the progeny will from this particular cells, the progeny will develop. In case of apomixis, here asexual reproduction is occurring. Apomixis is a part of asexual reproduction, but here seed production will occur. But the seeds are not produced through the fusion of the gamete. It is produced through some specialized way, like for example, apogamy, apospory, etc. Then two types of fertilization event, that they are autogamy or allogamy. Autogamy is the self-fertilization event, and allogamy is the cross-fertilization event. Based on the various ways which favor the self or cross-fertilization, there is cleistogamy. Cleistogamy is the condition where the fertilization occurs in an open flower bud. Then in case of chasmogamy, the flowers only open after the completion of the pollination. That condition is called as chasmogamy. Then in hercogamy, there is a hindrance present between the anther and the stigma, that is from your stamen and carpel, the transmission of the pollens is not possible because of the physical barrier, that is any sort of extension of the sepal or some structure of the flower which prevent the pollen to move to the particular own flower stigma. That condition is called hercogamy. Hercogamy favors allogamy or cross fertilization event. Then coming to the associated with self incompatibility and male sterility. Self incompatibility means here the pollens are fertile, but it cannot fertilize the same flower, but it can fertilize normally to cross other flowers. Then the condition that is male sterility. Male sterility condition where the pollen grains are totally non-functional. Okay, it cannot fertilize the self also or cross also. Then coming in male sterility, we'll see three lines, that is A line, B line and R line. A line is the male sterile line, which is used as the female parent in hybrid seed production. And here male sterile means only female part will be working normally. No pollen production will be there. So this prevents the way, in a way to prevent the contamination. Okay. There will be no number of self seeds. B line is the genotypic condition will be almost similar. It is the isogenic line to A line, but only the condition is that the B line is fertile one, but the A line is sterile one. Okay. And B line is used in cross with A cross B line. A line is crossed with B to produce and maintain the A line. That's why the B line is sometimes called as maintainer line. There's the third line, that is line is the any line which is male fertile in nature, and that is different from the genetic constitution that than that of A line. So A line and R line are crossed to produce the progeny in case of hybrid seed production. A line is the female line and R line becomes the male line. Then next term is the chemical hybridizing agent, that is a CHS. CHS are chemicals which are whenever sprayed or applied on the plant, they will selectively kill the pollens only. They will not affect the female organs. So the ovule and the ovary will grow normally, only the pollens will be hampered. So in turn, the plant will become male sterile. Coming to the next part, that is germplasm. Here the germplasm actually refers to the term that is a collection of individuals, but a particular species that may include landraces, improved varieties, old varieties, or any breeding stock which is developed in day-to-day breeding program, or any other lines. All the lines and wild relatives, everything comes under the germplasm condition. And germplasm, based on the storage, we can call them as active collection or base collection. Active collection when is the collection from where we are taking the material regularly for various purposes. But the base collection is the material which is not disturbed regularly. It is kept as a cold storage kind of thing, where it is kept for more number of years compared to active storage. And this is the viability is checked for the base collection in some 10 to 10 years, and each 10 years we need to check the viability of the seeds present in the base collection. Then coming to the thing that is broad genetic base. Here the genetic base indicates to the term that is whether high genetic variability is present in the particular plant or not. I am talking about the high genetic variability. Genetic variability means if you consider two terms, that is pure lines or mass selected varieties. Pure lines are also self-fertilized one, and mass selected ones also self-fertilizing plants. But the thing is that whenever we are going for the pure lines are produced from the single self-fertilized plant. That's why all the plants in the pure line are similar in genetic constitution. That's why there is no variability present among them. If any variability is present, that is because of environmental origin, not genetic variation is present. But the mass selected variety is composed of the plants that are belonging to different pure lines. Okay, so the mass selected variety is homozygous in nature, but it is heterogeneous in its total population structure. Okay, so it will be termed as the broad genetic base ones. Then coming to next term, that is center of origin. Center of origin was given by Babylob. Here what happened is, here based on the various geographical region and where the crop could have originated, on that possibility Babylob has divided the whole world's major areas into several center of origins, and each crop has a particular primary center of origin and secondary center of origin based on diversity and the origin of the particular crop. He has given. Then coming to the different terms based on the crosses, the first one is a single cross. In single cross, we used to cross two inbred or two pure lines. So the inbred or pure line, when I'm talking, the two parents in the cross need to be homozygous in nature. So pure lines and inbreds both are homozygous in nature. Pure line is the plant which is developed by self-pollination of the self-fertilizing plant itself. So it is completely homozygous. Inbred line is the progeny of self-fertilization event from a cross-pollinated plant. So it is also homozygous in nature, but it may be have some little bit, but not much. So in single crosses, normally we use pure lines or inbreds. Coming to double cross, here what happens is two single cross events are going on. A, B is the one single cross, C, D is one single cross. So between them we are crossing whatever the progeny coming out of A and B and whatever the progeny coming out of C and D, they are crossed with each other to produce the double cross. Then coming to the next term, that is back cross. In back cross, you can see the normally the F1, that is A and B, if the parent two parent are crossed. So if the progeny, that is F1, is crossed with any of the parent, that is either with A or B, that is condition is called back cross. Okay. And whenever it is crossed with the only recessive parent, it is called as test cross. Then coming to the breeding cross or breed species, what happens is if you want to cross A and B, A, B and Let's begin with the history of land grading. Here we I have listed down some of the important terms of the important history of the land grading, not all, because that is important from your examination point of view. So here Camer Arias is the important scientist who has demonstrated first sex in case of plant. This particular year is important. Here it is telling that 1717 Thomas Fairchild developed the Fairchild mule by crossing the two parents, that is two ornamental plants, Sweet William with Carnation. In Bill Morin has given the progeny test. This is important. Who has given the progeny test? Darwin has published the book, that is Origin of Species. Rimpo in 1890. This year is important. Rimpo has made the cross, that is triticale, by crossing the two lines, that is wheat into rye. Wheat, it is sickle triticum astipum, and crossed it with sickle cereal. Then Johansen has proposed the pure line theory in 1903. This is also important. Then Vavilov has identified 8 main centers and 3 sub-centers of the diversity. And he has also proposed the law of homologous series of variation. This law states that whenever a trait is present in a particular crop, the similar kind of trait might be found in the related crops also. Then Kapenchenko has given... Kapenchenko has produced the first intergeneric hybrid, that is the Ruffana brassica, by crossing the radish and cabbage. But the cross was not successful because he wanted to develop radish underground and cabbage above ground, but he got the opposite kind of trait. Okay, so upper ground part like radish and the below ground part like that of cabbage. So it couldn't succeed with the particular crop. Then this is important that Borlaug has got the Nobel Prize in 1970. That is the Nobel Peace Prize. Then C.T. Patel, he has developed the first cotton hybrid, that is H4. And he is also called as father of cotton. Then in 1991, Icrisat has produced the first PGNP hybrid, that is ICPH8. And Icrisat, important thing is that it has 6 mandate crops like pearl millet, PGNP, chickpea, finger millet, groundnut, etc. Then 1994, Flabbersberg tomato was developed by anti-GMO technique. Then in 1995, BT corn was developed. This is not much important. This one is important. Then this one is also important, that PPFRA Act was given in, came into force in case of 2001. Then I have some important leaders, that is T.S. Venkatraman. He is the person who, that is, he is an eminent sugar breeder. B.P. Pal, this name is very, very important. He was the first DG of ICAR and he is an eminent wheat breeder. Then M.S. Swaminathan, he is the person who brought the Green Revolution in India. Then Pushkar Nath is a famous potato breeder. Among all the scientists, if you have time, you can just have a look on them. Like, only remember the crop names and the scientist name, that's it. The important ones I already mentioned. Like from here, C.T. Patel and Ramaya is important. Ramaya, K. Ramaya is a renowned rice breeder. And he was the director of CRRA Cuttack. Then C.T. Patel is the famous cotton breeder. And he was famous for the first hybrid. So that is all about today's discussion. Okay. If you don't have any queries, we can end the session now. Thank you, everyone.
1994, Flavisaver tomato was developed by anti-GMO.